Out in the field, in places far and near, the Paxa social workers explained what the government was doing for them. These are the people whom the Paxa aided, victims of floods and typhoons, victims of outlaws, needy people waiting for government help. And here is the help. More people waiting for Paxa aid. Welcome, Syrian indeed. We rise, yes, we are rise from the government to the people. In 1948 alone, the Paxa reached 40 provinces and served, directly or indirectly, about 2 million people. These small farmers needed government help too. They needed some capital to start with. So the government, through the Paxa, gave them cash loans. About 1,500 deserving farmers of Central and Southern Luzon and other troubled areas received loans amounting to 220,000 pesos last year. About 16,000 farmers were given seeds worth 432,000 pesos. Now they can go back to work. The Philippine farmer, an industrious and honest man, the backbone of the nation, is working on his farm again. Another signal victory for the government. Meeting the rice emergency was only one part of the government job. Here the Rice and Corn Production Administration planned the 10-year program of rice production in the Philippines. The MBC Board of Directors in conference with Secretary Mapa, the RCPA officials, discussed the plans with Managing Director Felipe Buencamino and Director of Plant Industry Felix Maramba. From Isabela in the north to Cotabato in the south, the government rice projects have either been started or mapped out. The sum of 5 million pesos have been allocated to start the Ala Valley in Cotabato. These projects have a total area of 443,000 hectares of virgin land. 111,000 farmers and their families are now working on that. This is the RCPA camp in Ala Valley, Cotabato. Work was started here this year. And before the harvest, harmful insects are smoked out. Here is the first harvest. Mechanized harvesting, mechanized plowing, mechanized threshing. These are a few houses built by the farmers themselves. While farm is being harvested, moon settlement houses are being constructed. For there is no virgin land to be converted into rice fields. Tibet land tax men now being thrown up to produce more rice for the people. To fund the RCPA program, we now come to another settlement. This is the Bukid Moon project. The tractor is out to convert corn fields into rice producing farms. This certainly is mechanized warfare on idle lands. Yes, the Philippines is a rich country. Another tractor on its way to new areas. And still another. 25,000 hectares of fertile land for more rice. The beginnings of a new settlement, a humble house, pioneer farmers, modern mechanized implements. Director Maramba himself started the Bukid Moon project. Here he is inspecting the camp site and giving instructions. We are proud of these pioneer farmers. And now the boys, it's chow time. You can't work well on an empty stomach, can you? These farmers are about ready to go to the field to bring out the wealth in the wide sea of fertile soil all around them. And there is their annual tractors to put life into idle land. Farming, the modern manner, quick, efficient, sure. Hinterland turned into rings of rich, wild soil. Well done, boys.